Welcome at tutorial number 22 of the EEP10 Model Railway Simulator. In the past few tutorials, we have been working on an entry control system for Station South, and in the end it seemed to work well. And now we would like to have also an entry system for Station North. So let's have a look if we can accomplish that. Open up the program. And if you would open up the file that we've last saved, then we would end up in 2D mode something like this. This is our station south, and we have been, let me click on the signaling system, we have been working on quite a few signals to control that the entry of the station is such that a train always goes to a free track and they will never collide. It works. However, we needed some logic in that. If I click, for instance, this sensor and then right-click it, what we needed once was an if-then statement. We needed to do to switch something, let's say a junction or a signal, depending on if a track was occupied. And that is this if statement. If a certain signal is at hold, then we need to do something. That logic we needed, and we could use that for Station South because there are only two tracks. There's only one if statement that we can use, and well, luckily we only had to ask about one lane if it was occupied or not. At Station North, however, the situation is more complex. If I want to know if I need to close this signal, then I need an if-then statement if track 2 is occupied, and if track 3 is occupied, and if track 4 is occupied. Well, I cannot do that because I have only one if-then statement available. We need something else to work on it. There is no logic language built in EP, so what we need to do is create a sort of mechanical switching circuit. And that can be done by adding some streets or tracks and let a switching car drive over that and switch junctions and signals. It's best to just do it and then explain at the end why it works, and instead of the other way around. If I start to try to explain now, it won't work very well, I bet. Let's zoom in a little bit on this. Wait a moment, right left click, zoom in a little bit over here. This is the place where we are going to build our tracks. We are going to use street tracks for that, and let us select from the list the Veldweg, this one. And we are going to start with a switch, and that switch has a length, a right click on it, a length of 10 and an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, and then I need to double click it a few times such that it looks like this. Yes, now we are going to select it and make a copy, but a backwards copy. Yes, so now we have a situation like this. Again, we are going to add a switch and we give it a length of 10 and we keep it straight this time. And we connect it over here. This one we copy, but be careful, we forward copy 1, 2, 3 times, so that now we have 4 of those straight ones. Then one more, but that I'm going to shift over here, and we make also forward copies of those. That's it for the switches. Now we are going to the rails without a switch. We need 2 straights of 10. Okay, let us connect this one over here and forward copy it and connect the other one over there. And now what we need is a bunch of curves. The curve is 180 degrees, so half a circle, and the length is 20. Okay, are you still with me? I rotate it twice by double clicking and another time double clicking, and then I make a forward copy, and that is the one that I am going to use a few times. So let's do it and fill up all these circles with all these switches that we have been building. It's just a matter of clicking and copy and pasting, and be careful that everything keeps going smooth and well. Yes, we are doing great. This is the last copy, because now we don't need any more copies. We can simply use this one and connect it over here, and it will snap into place. This is the situation where we end up at. Oh, I don't like the location of this switch. So let's click that switch and right click it, and we can manually control where it needs to be. I want it to be at the right side, so it looks a bit better. It has now the same location as all the others. Well, if you have been trying to work with me, you should have something like this. And now let's try to see how we can use this as a control circuit for the entry of Station North. We are going to let a car drive over this street, and the first situation that we are going to have is this one. And the easiest thing to think of is that all the tracks are occupied by a train, and no free tracks, all are occupied. And my control car is driving around in this circle. This is the wait for a request circle. It's just waiting and doing nothing, actually. Over here, we are going to build in a sensor that says a train is coming and it is looking for a free spot on the station. So when that sensor is hit, then we do the following. We open this switch. So this is a simple sensor to open that switch. Now the car is driving along this loop, and this is what we call the wait loop. We are waiting until a track comes free. Yes, so nothing is happening again until one of the trains in the station is leaving. Well, let's keep things easy for now. Track 1, this train on track 1 is leaving, so at the other side of the station there is a sensor that says, yeah, I am now gone, and that sensor throws this switch. This is the switch for track 1, and you can already imagine this is track 2, track 3, track 4. Yeah, so the car was waiting in the wait loop, but now all of a sudden it is going this way. And this is the path where we are going to place some sensors that do all the necessary actions. Well, there are a few actions. First of all, of course, for track 1 we need to make sure that the switch for track 1 is going to be switched correctly. As we see over here, that switch needs to go to vaart. Can we see that? How can we see that? Well, we can see that if I click over here. Yes, right click it and it says vaart. So over here we build a first sensor that says that switch number 8 should go to vaart. Well, that's easy. Then over here we build a second sensor that says, well, you can now open the signal over here. Yes, that's also easy. And then we are going to work on our control system again. Then we build another sensor that says, okay, track 1 is now occupied again, so let us throw this switch back to its occupied position. And finally, we are going to throw this switch back to the wait for a request loop. So my car did the following. It was waiting. Over here there was suddenly a request, so it started driving over here. And then a train has left, and that opened up track 1, and my car one time only passed all these four signals, and the signal said, throw the switch, throw the signal over here, throw my own switch, and throw this switch back to waiting loop. Well, this is how a control circuit works. Are we now finished? No, because we have not even started to build it. We need to include all these sensors that I have been talking about. And that is what we are going to do in the next video. See you over there.